you know, it was just a crazy idea to get your friends together and start losing body fat, but make it a competition. Put numbers behind it. Let's see who outperforms the other. And in the meantime, yeah, we can have some fun doing it.
Hey, I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah. I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. The body fat competition started back in 1998. We just did our 11th, we do it every 2 years. Some people ask me, how do we start this? Why did this start? How did it start? And I tell them, it started as a bet between four friends that turned into something that we got a little bit more sophisticated, where people signed a lot of documents and contracts, and we made a lot of rules that work for a lot of the guys that did this, and it's been a big success.
Ultimately, what we strive for is to create a system, or at least acknowledge that you have to have a healthier lifestyle. If we learn anything, we learn how to better our lives, to better our families, to better our health. And if we walk away from here after 3 months knowing that, we've had a successful body fat challenge. So we meet all together. We have what we call the Last Supper. We sign contracts. Now, these contracts are important because they're a legal document. You sign your name and you give a deposit. If you do not perform your part of it, that check is going to be cashed. All handled by accountants and lawyers. So it's all legit.
I'm trying to live my life, but am I doing it right? Tell me I'm the man, you're the man right now. You're the man right now with the whole wide world in the palm of your hand right now. The lights and the cameras and the money and the fame, I'ma do it for the fam right now. I'ma get it for the 301 and the RATTPAC, cause you know I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah. I work hard every day, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, but today is my day, it's my day.
I'm sure you're curious about how this whole thing works. So I'll tell you, 70% of your score is all body fat. 10% of your score is a bike, 10% of your score is a 1 mile sprint run, and another 10% you get from a 150 meter swim. All timed, all very fast, and they all matter. So I'll tell you a little bit of how we deal with the losers. Once we have the final 20% list of losers at the end of the bike ride, we take them to the restaurant, we gather them, everybody comes around, and we start shaving their heads in different shapes. We leave a clump of hair on one side, nothing on the other. We go straight down the middle, depending on what creativity the one that shaves has. The one that shaves is usually the winner of the entire competition. But after a few times, you feel bad and you start giving it to other people. So it's actually a fun part of this whole thing.
It was 41 guys that lost a total of 820 pounds. It's been an incredible experience for a lot of guys.
So a big inspiration for all of us was Gus Cabrera. Gus Cabrera came in second in the overall competition, but he came in first in the body fat component of it. With an amazing almost 60 pounds lost, he reduced his body fat percent by 62%, which is an all-time record in the body fat challenge, and completely transformed his body and his life. He lost an average of 0.75 pounds each day of 91-day period of the BFC. An amazing accomplishment. I've had friends along the years that have participated in the Body Fat Challenge, but for some reason I never have. I've either been too busy or maybe a little too worried I wasn't going to be able to dedicate the time and I was going to end up with my head shaved. So this year I mustered the courage to do it, and I got to tell you, it's the best decision I ever made. I discovered things about myself that I never knew were possible and transformed my life in the process, transformed my health, and created a lot of amazing friendships that I never had before. I encourage anybody to do this. It will change their lives, and it's a moment in my life that I'll never forget.
And what's exciting is how we've developed and how it's gone forward with technology. All of a sudden we have a lot of camaraderie between the group. Everybody's talking to each other. Then I think next year is going to be even better. So I urge you guys, the ones that maybe are listening to this for the first time and have never done it, talk to the guys that have done it and see how their lives have changed, because it's going to make a big difference for you and for the rest of your families.
I'm like, hey, BFC, right here, a little bit of secrets, set yourself for success, baby. Try to get it down, hold on.
That is a lot of water.
Almost a gallon. A little more. You want crazy? That, but I can't give you all my secrets.
Love it. Hey guys, hope everyone's doing well. I thought I would put together a little piece here because there's been something that's really been bothering me. You know, I've been both entertained and tormented by these videos that Julian keeps posting. You know, Julian is a ferocious guy, and I'm a little worried about him. So I thought I would try to compete with him on something that I can compete with. You know, I saw him struggling with that chlorophyll water the other day, and so we decided to solicit the help of my 23-year-old daughter and her boyfriend, who are experts, and we put together this invention called the shredder. Let me show you how it works. Ready? So we take the chlorophyll water, we load it in, and we pray. Voila, works really well, increases your red blood cell count, and I think it might be worthwhile incorporating this as a sport in the BFC next year. This goes back to my days at Christopher Columbus High School, where I learned this from guys like Cesar Sordo, Guido Hernandez, and Paul Padron, which are world class at this sport. If we include this, they might have a fighting chance to win the BFC. Thank you very much.
All right, guys, good ride today. But for some of us, it wasn't good enough. So we're all at the beach, eating juicy hamburgers, cheeseburgers, little cute cupcakes and cookies. Some of us are out here working on starting sprints. Why would you ask? Do you need a starting sprint? Not a finish sprint, a start sprint. Well, I don't f***ing know. It doesn't make any sense. But that's the way this group wants us to do a bike race, with a starting sprint. So I'm doing 10 miles of starting sprints on the mountain bike. Yeah, I'm hitting the 30 miles an hour. It's looking good. You won't catch me sleeping next time. See you in a couple of weeks.